Hi, Shep Hyken here, customer service and experience expert. And today I'm going to teach you how to calculate your customer retention rate. Now get ready to do a little math. While this is not my typical lesson, it's still very important. After all, customer retention can lead to customer loyalty, and loyal customers are important to all businesses, regardless of industry or size, large or small, B2B or B2C. Most businesses know their numbers, but do they know the right numbers? It's easy to measure customer satisfaction at different levels. We find out how they liked their experience. We know that if they like the experience, that's the first step in getting them to come back. The getting them to come back number is different than the were you happy with us number. I'd love for customers to rate our business as a 5 out of 5 every time, but the number that is always most important, maybe even more so, is the one that proves to us that the customer comes back. That's your customer retention number. If this is of interest to you, and it should be, then get out a pad of paper and a pencil. It probably wouldn't hurt to have a calculator either. And let's get started. Now, according to Zendesk, the customer retention rate measures the number of customers a company continues to do business with over a given period of time. It's a percentage of existing customers that maintain loyalty to the business within that window of time. The formula for calculating customer retention is really pretty simple. First, you need 3 pieces of information. You need the S, which is the number of existing customers at the start of the period of time. You need an N, which is the number of new customers added in the period of time. And you need an E, which is the total number of customers at the end of the period of time. To calculate the rate, first, subtract the number of new customers added over that period of time, represented by the letter N, from the total number of customers at the end of that same period of time. That's represented by the letter E. That's E minus N. Then divide that number by the number of customers at the start of the period of time, represented by the letter S. Finally, multiply that number by 100 and you'll have the percentage of customers who stay. Now, obviously, the closer you are to 100%, the better. Very few companies can say, we retain 100% of our customers. But if you're close, you're in the zone. When you continue to bring in new customers and get existing ones to return, that's a recipe for success and growth. Well, I hope you enjoyed this short lesson. Thank you very much for tuning in. This is Shep Hyken reminding you to always be amazing.